Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, you might be aware of the fact that we also have a series in which what we do, we daily discuss some questions for the purpose of your prelims 2020. So the name of this series is Let's Solve Some Questions for Prelims 2020. So as is clear from its name, so it is not just about solving the questions, but it is also about your participation in the discussion. So the purpose of this naming this as Let's Solve Some Question is that you people show participation in it. So you people, we request you people to comment in the comment box if you have any additional information as well. So your participation will certainly be welcomed. So let's start our discussion. So the topic that we will be going to discuss today is geography. From geography we will be asking you questions. So the first question is, consider the following statements. First, at a given apparent position of sun in the sky, all places on the same longitude receive the same amount of solar insolation. Second, sun is overhead at the same time for all locations with the same latitude. Which of the above is are correct? So we have to choose that. So friends, let me tell you that both of these statements are incorrect. Why these both of these are incorrect? Because take for example, if you are living in India and suppose one of your friend you live in Gujarat, and one of your friends live in some northeastern state. So if suppose we take that there is a line of longitude that connects your place to the place of your friend, so you will see that both lie on the same longitude, but solar insolation at the same time may not be the same. Because at a given apparent position, so for example, if northeastern states see the sunrise earlier, so that's why your western state will see the sunrise later. So obviously insolation, amount of insolation at a particular position of the sun will differ. So Gujarat will be receiving different solar insolation, but northeastern state in which your friend lives, it might be receiving different solar insolation. So first is not correct. So certainly second can be correct. This is very easy, because if for example sun is on equator, and how then for example sorry I have given you the wrong example. For if the first, the example which I have given to Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh, this is applicable for second statement. And for first statement, take for example position, you live in Kashmir and your friend lives in Tamil Nadu. So obviously if at a particular place sun is there over a particular longitude, then certainly the different areas, that is the with respect to the equator, if for example sun is on equator, then you are right, it is not necessary that a place that is north towards the equator on the same longitude and the one that is south towards on the same longitude that will receive same sunlight, because that will be different. So answer would be D, none. So here is the explanation. So in simple words you can read this explanation. So this explanation has quite become complex due to the confusion. You can read it in simple words, that is solar insolation depends on both longitude and latitude. So for example, even if northeastern state and western state are at same latitude, they would not see sun overhead at the same time, so there will be a time lag. So also then similarly, if a northern and southern state are at same longitude, they do not receive the same amount of solar insolation. So depending upon their apparent position of the sun in the sky, places close to ITCZ would receive greater insolation. So that is the thing. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. Assertion is, oil and gas deposits cannot be found in sandstones and coarse-grained limestones. Reason is, structural traps cannot be formed in sandstones and limestones. So here in this context, we have to choose that which of these is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these are incorrect, because in fact mostly the oil and gas deposits are found in sandstones limestones and a coarse grained limestone rock structures. So they simple in simple words, these sandstones and coarse grained limestones are a type of hard sponge which have pores in them, but they are hard, they cannot be compressed. So mostly they trap in due to their structure, due to their holes in them, the oil, the gas or the water. So all oil and gas deposits are found in structural and stratigraphic traps, and most of them are found in sandstones and coarse grained limestones. So this is the thing. So piece of sandstone or limestone is very much like a hard sponge full of holes but not compressible. So these holes or pores can contain water or oil or gas. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following matches of rivers with their origin source. First, Narmada, Mekal Hill, second, Chambal, Singar, Pachori Peak, third, Tapi, Satpura Range. So we have to choose that which of these is correctly matched. So let me tell you friends that all of these is correctly matched. All of these are correctly matched. First is correct. Narmada originates from Mekal Hill. The Mekal Hills are a part of your... Mekal is a range, so in it there is Amarkantak Plateau. There is Amarkantak Plateau, which is the main source of Narmada. And then Chambal originates from Singar Chori Peak. So this is basically we can say a part of this Singar Chori Peak is a northern escarpment of Vindhyan Range. So then Satpura originates, this Tapi originates from Satpura Range. So all of these are correctly matched. So Amarkantak is the place where the Narmada River originates, and then it mainly flows in central India and drains into your Arabian Sea. And then Chambal River originates from Singar Chori Peak on the northern slope of Vindhyan Escarpment. And the river rises, Tapti River rises in the eastern Satpura Range of southern Madhya Pradesh and flows westward, draining Madhya Pradesh, Nimar region, Maharashtra's Khandesh, and east Vidarbha regions in the northwest corner of Deccan Plateau and south Gujarat before emptying into the Gulf of Cambay of the Arabian Sea. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, which one of the following matches is incorrect? A. Gobi Desert, Mongolia. B. Bering Strait International Dateline. C. Mount Kilimanjaro, Africa. D. Andes Mountain, South Africa. So we have to choose that which of these is incorrectly matched. So let me tell you friends, the answer is D. Andes Mountain is in South America and not in South Africa. So Mount Kilimanjaro is the dormant volcano that is there in Tanzania in Africa. So Bering Strait is the international dateline. It also separates USA and Russia. And then this Gobi Desert is in Mongolia. So Mount Kilimanjaro is a dormant volcano in Tanzania, and also please note it that it is the highest mountain in Africa. So Mount Kilimanjaro, so it is a dormant volcano. Then Gobi Desert is a vast arid region in the northern China as well as in southern Mongolia. So it is not exclusively in Mongolia. So UPSC has the habit of asking such statements that Gobi Desert exclusively lies in Mongolia. So it's known for its dunes, mountains and rare animals like snow leopards and Bactrian camels. So then Bering Strait is a strait connecting the Pacific and Arctic Oceans. So and also between this Russia and United States. So international dateline runs equidistant between Straits Diomede Islands at a distance of 1.5 km. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following factors affect the generation and flow of equatorial westerlies? First, movement of intertropical convergence zone. Second, Coriolis force caused due to rotation of Earth. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So if intertropical convergence zone is shifting, for example in summers, your intertropical convergence zone where these tropical winds meet, it shifts towards northern hemisphere. It moves towards the north of the Earth due to intensive heating of the land in the northern part of the Earth. So then this movement causes southeasterly winds that are there, or we can say southeasterly wind to cross over to the equator, and then it flows towards the westward direction due to the Coriolis force. So this can be better understood by reading NCERTs. So this is the answer, C. So friends, this is all about today's discussion. So if you are scoring 5 out of 5, 4, 3, then you are good and you are performing well. And if you are scoring 1, 2, 0, then it is 2, very good, very good. In fact, why I'm saying this? Because at least you have seen the video in which you didn't knew some questions and you got to know about them. So that is the thing, that is what the rule of gradual progression says. So gradual, keep your keep walking, no matter how, keep moving forward. You might be aware of that quote of running and then walking and then crawling. So do whatever, but keep moving forward. So that is a good thing. Don't do this thing that you will not see videos because you are unable to attempt the questions, you are scoring less, because it is not the thing. The thing is not that somebody is scoring this much and what I am scoring. The thing is at the end, how everybody will perform in the prelims. So that is the main thing. So prepare yourself for that day. So friends, also if you are interested in our series, that is we have all geography NCRT series from 6 to 12 with the that in which we cover your all NCRTs from 6 to 12th in just rupees 149. So in this series, daily target is given to you, and evening you are given 10 MCQs from that target, and all NCRTs of geography from 6 to 10th are covered in 45 days. So in this way you get 10 into 45, that is 450 MCQs on the basis of NCRT at the end of the 45th day. So single magazine is shared with you people on the 45th day, which will be the compilation of all 450 NCRT based MCQs. So how it will benefit you? So obviously friends, there is no point in saying that NCRTs are very important for you. So NCRTs are the foundations. So most of the toppers and leading institutions recommend these NCRTs, and each and every NCRT of geography will be covered from class 6 to 12th, and then coverage of entire geography then will be through MCQ mode. So it will ensure discipline in your studies, because in today's world of internet connectivity, most students are preparing from home. So they are not in urban areas or metropolitan areas for their preparation or coaching classes. So the issue they face is the lack of discipline in their studies. So this daily based targets will ensure discipline in your studies, because you will have to prepare the target of the day so that you can solve the MCQs in the evening. And then also problem of revising NCRTs will also be solved, because at the end of a series you will be given 450 MCQs based, and their in detail explanations will be there. So these explanations will be much comprehensive, and all important topics that will be there in your geography NCRTs, they will be covered through these 450 MCQs. So in this way you will be able to revise through a single document, and you need not revise NCRTs again and again. So then also geography NCRTs are believed to be the most comprehensive NCRTs among all NCRTs, and also mere reading is not enough. You must know how the UPSC frames questions, because reading is also done by a person who is studying in 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th or 11th or 12th class. So you must be preparing yourself in a way that you are able to attempt the exam of UPSC, and you must prepare in a way that you crack it. So obviously here lies the difference in your strategy of reading. So this can only happen if you do practice, if you solve MCQs, and also then disciplined preparation gives you much needed self-confidence, because when you have a daily target, you prepare it for it, and then you complete your syllabus in a disciplined manner, then self-confidence automatically develops in you. And then now is the best time, because prelims is just 6 months away. So if you are waiting for anything, then I don't know what you are waiting for. So do ensure that you join it as soon as possible, if in case you are interested. So the link is shown here on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box. So you can check the description box, use this link to join, and can then when you will join, we will contact you, and you will be then enrolled for the course. And also friends, we have a Telegram channel, the link of which is also given in description box. So on that Telegram channel we have more than 15,000 subscribers that are having access to our various resources that we share for the purpose of CSE preparation. So these resources are publicly available to everyone who is there in our Telegram channel. So do ensure that you check the description box and join the Telegram channel, so that you also avail yourselves of such or public resources that we share for the purpose of CSE preparation. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.